My paper. Good morning, students. We will start today the next point. See, in the separation of substances, we have completed the many different methods how to separate the substance from a mixture. Okay. So many methods we discussed yesterday. Before this lecture, we discussed about the filtration, how exactly filtration we have to do, and how many mixtures we can separate with the help of the filtration, evaporation, sedimentation, decantation. Okay, these all methods we discuss. But now, today, the next point we will see, that is the separation of mixture by using more than one method. Means in this point, only one method is not sufficient to separate the mixture. So for that, we have to use the different methods, means more than one method to separate that particular mixture. Okay. Now see here one example, that is the mixture of sand and salt. See, before this mixture of sand and salt, okay, how to separate this? Just think about how we can separate this mixture. See, suppose in this one container, okay, in the beaker, here some sand particles, okay, sand particles, as well as in this some salt particles. Now this is the totally, this is the mixture of sand and salt. Okay, now tell me how to separate this. By hand picking method we can separate? No, because sand size, particle size also very small, and salt also, so we can't use that. So for this, which method we will use? See, first what we will use, we add these both the mixture in one beaker, means in a water. Now here water is there and we will add a mixture. Okay, just stir it. Okay, stir with the help of this spatula. Now what will happen? The salt, all salt will dissolve in water. Okay, salt will dissolve in water, but this sand will dissolve in water? No, sand will be remain, because sand is an insoluble water and salt is a soluble in water. So salt will dissolve in water and sand will be remain. Now here which method we will use? Now here the method we will use, that is the decantation. Okay, which method we will use? Decantation. Okay, now this is the first method, decantation method we use. So with the help of decantation method, what we will separate? Will separate. Now see, in now here what, this water we will pour in a another beaker. Okay, now here we will get just salt water. Okay, now why salt water? Because salt is a soluble in this water. See, with the help of decantation, what we separated? Sand we will get here separate, that sediment one layer we will get here. Okay, but now still here salt is remaining. Now what we will use? Here we will use the method, that is the evaporation. Okay, now when you will heat this mixture, what, the steam will comes out, and with the help of this steam, what will happen? The water will evaporate it and we will get the salt. And suppose if we want this water also, then we will use the next, it is condensation. Okay, so to separate this sand and salt, which method we use first? First is the decantation method, next one is evaporation method, or next another one, which one is another one? Tell me fast. First is the decantation, then evaporation or condensation method. Okay, so this mixture we separate by using more than one method. What do you understand this point? Okay, so separation of mixtures by using more than one method. So here the one example, sand and salt. Like that you think another example. See, this, now This sand we can separate by using filtration method also. Okay, means residue whatever we will get, that is the sand, and water will remain. So filtration also we can use here, and the remaining water we have to separate the salt. For that we use the condensation or evaporation method. Okay, so more than one method how to use for the separation of the mixture. So this is one example. Do you understand it? Read this point carefully. It is all the point it is given in your textbook. Remaining points we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.